multiplication using the standard algorithm. The word algorithm just means a set of steps you take to complete a task. The standard algorithm is just the one that most people seem to use. Let's try it out on this. 452 times 67. We line up the figures like this, biggest number on top, and put in the multiplication sign. The squared paper in your math book is perfect for helping you set it out. We multiply in stages. On the first line here, we multiply by 7, and on the second line, by 60. Before I start to multiply, I put a line in here. This is a modification to the standard algorithm that I make for beginning students' success. It gives us a space in which we can put those carried or regrouped digits, and that defined space helps us to succeed. Let's go. First we say 7 times 2. That's 14. The ones part goes here and the tens part goes up above the line and directly above the next figure we are about to multiply. Now we do 7 times 5. That's 35. And add this one, which makes 36. And now 7 times 4. 28, and we add in this 3, so that gives us 31. Before I start the next line of multiplication, I cross out those digits we carried or regrouped before. We've added them once, we do not want to accidentally add them a second time. And now I'm ready for the next line. We're going to multiply this by 6. It's not 6 ones though, is it? It's the 60 part of 67. It's 6 tens. And as you know, when you multiply by tens, you put a zero on the end. We put in a zero before we multiply anything on the second line. All right, now 6 times 2 is 12. Next, 6 times 5 is 30, and the one we carried, that's 31. And then we have 6 times 4, that's 24, plus that 3 we carried, that's 27. And that's the multiplication stage all done. Now we add both rows to solve the problem. So, in the ones column, we've got 4. Then, 6 and 2 is 8. Next, 1 and 1 is 2. 3 and 7 is 10. And 1 and 2 is 3. Our answer is 30,284. And that's the standard algorithm in use. So, to review, everything times your ones digit on the first line. On the second line, we're multiplying by tens, so put a zero first, then it's everything times your tens digit. If you're multiplying by a three-digit number, well, on the third line, you're into the hundreds column, and when we multiply by hundreds, we put two zeros on the end. So you start the third line with two zeros and then multiply away. Add up to finish off. In the ones column, 2, then 8. 4 and 6 is 10, and 1 is 11. This is 7, 9, 10. Here we've got 5 and 1. Done. Note taking is important. Watch the video again and copy down each step. Then you get a worked example in your math book to help you. Use the standard algorithm for yourself and build some more math muscle.